Dear Sinai Rahman and friends, dear Frederick, dear friends of McDonald's, the Dutch Connection, ladies and gentlemen, this is what I got to know. A young man of mixed race, born in uncharted territory, destined to have a splendid future in business, went whaling instead. He had himself stranded onto the shores of an unknown island in close territory on the other side of the biggest ocean of the world. He was captured and made himself useful to his captors. His name was Ronald McDonald, and we are talking about events in the month around October 11, 1848. As I myself was conceived in Amsterdam and born in the Republic of Indonesia, studied chemistry and epistemology, and finally became skipper, Ronald McDonald intrigued me. I traced his footsteps a couple of years ago, and last year decided to create an award bearing his name for outstanding work, as Ansel already told, by a debut writer or artist on international relations, in particular those between Asia, Europe and North America.
It's me now, you know.
Two long-time friends were prepared to help me out. Ernst, Fritz, he studied chemistry. We studied chemistry together, and he's now an historian of science and technology. Fritz is a forester, and he's now a land and real estate agent. So he's doing the money. That's a very safe idea. Consequently, today, October 11, 2016, I'm honored to announce, on behalf of the Board of Friends of McDonald's, the Dutch Connection, the first ever winner of the Ronald McDonald Award, as well as exceptionally honorary winner of the Ronald McDonald Prize. Dear Zia Haider Rahman, the first chapter of your first book, published by Hollands Diep as In het licht van wat wij weten, starts with a quotation of Edward Said about exile, which is applicable to Ronald McDonald when he went whaling instead of trading. It's followed by a second quotation by Joost Koenraad about blank spaces on the earth applicable to the region of North, and this is applicable to the region of North America where McDonald was born. In those days, it was white. And the third quotation about true places never being on the map, taken from Melville's Moby Dick, which might be read as a description of the hardly known spot where McDonald had himself strangled, and it was by will. The opening sentence of your book reads, in the early hours of 1 September morning 2008, there appeared on the doorstep of our home in South Kensington a brown-skinned man, haggard and gaunt, if I had to say it well, the ridges of his cheekbones set above an unkempt beard. I like to think, you're the only one who knows, don't tell me, because this is a cliffhanger, I like to think it was Saturday, September 20, 9:30 local time. I'll come back to that. In paragraph 3 of your book, the narrator explicitly lays out its framework. The reader is going to get a visitor with notebooks in his back and very much to tell at the kitchen table. He also gets his listening and recording friend, the narrator, who is forced to get back to the shared past with his visitor and to his own past during his visitor's absence. And in order to finally sort things out and write the book, your book, he is writing it, he needs to do a lot of research into details, because as a man of finance, he is only interested in detail as far as the broad picture is concerned. The narrator even summarizes the book, your book again, before he starts writing it. It will be, I cite, the story of the breaking of nations, war in the 21st century, marriage into the English aristocracy, and the mathematics of life. And now it starts. But really, we have the frame, and really, bit by bit the framework is filled in. Not starting in one corner to enter in the opposite, but more like pieces are taken and tried, put back, parts are laid, regardless of what is already there, waiting for the moment that it can get connected. In the meantime, every well-laid piece, a couple of pieces of an image worth contemplating. Contemplation takes time. Reading a book takes time, which is very, very nice. The reader gets to see image after image, panoramas, spreads, snapshots, and everything in between. Of class differences here and over there. Of longing for love to the very opposite and not getting it. Of psychoanalysis and music. Of warfare and the fruitless attempts to master its consequences. Of betrayal and foul play. Of then, now, and the relation between the two. Of science, law, finance, and the value of the knowledge accumulated in them. Of cartography, semantics, linguistics, of the Union Jack, of religion, of Europe, Asia, North America. There's even a couple of images of Africa. And the Nehru color is mentioned, once off, once on. There's nearly an end. The pictures are in high resolution. The reader can zoom into the pixel, which now and then appears to be not a pixel, but a picture itself. At the very end of your book, a piece is missing or held back by the visitor or the narrator. What the reader does know about this piece is the place, the time, and the people involved. Above all, he gets to know that it is an image of rage of the visitors, so all-encompassing that it ultimately did not care for confirmation, and he became the instrument of his fury. I read this as references to Gödel's incompleteness theory and to Freud's agieren, was er lacht, acting out. But that's all the reader gets. The context is the book, is your book, the missing piece, the main event. And the visitor already told the narrator, everything new is on the rim of our view, in the darkness below the horizon, so that nothing new is visible within the light of what we know. Your book shows that at every level, the light in which we see the relations between Asia, Europe and North America is fading or has already faded. I understand this as a new light being shed onto the old. Your book is as true can be in fiction. It is as morally good as good can be, the times and places described, and certainly beautiful in its tone, fully supporting the first two criteria. Therefore, Sia Aile Rahman, may I convey to you my warm congratulations on behalf of the board of Friends of McDonald's, the Dutch Connection, and invite you to come forward to receive the Ronald McDonald's Award 2016 for your debut novel in a lift from Batman 8.